drive past. Dear old Humboldt State, hillside haven for alternate realities. The North Coast School.
The Dream Gallery composer and lyricist Mark Abel on the song Adam and soloist Tom Zohar.
The Redwoods. Gently fading now.
Our final character is a young man named Adam, and he lives in a town called Arcata, which is up on the north coast in Humboldt County. It's right across the bay from Eureka, which is a name that people know a little bit better than Arcata. But there's a university there, Humboldt State University, and it's been known for many years as a counterculture haven. And today, it's really one of the last bastions of the kind of counterculture spirit that you could easily find in California in the 60s and 70s. I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that he's a student, or actually he's just graduated. He's a young person who hasn't made some of the most crucial life decisions. And so he's kind of musing about that he got through college, but he doesn't really know what he wants to do next. And as a lot of us know, that can be a kind of a poignant struggle, and especially at a time of economic dislocation. I can imagine a lot of young people wanting to postpone these decisions as long as they possibly could. And so he's kind of still caught up in the reverie of the environment there, and being around a lot of other energetic and intelligent young people who would like to probably do environmental jobs or you know, do good for the world. And there only being a certain number of positions available for that sort of thing. So he's trying to think through his life. And I had a great time in a way writing this piece, because I really had to draw on what I felt like when I was 21 years old and wasn't really sure at all what I was going to be doing. And I was able to kind of access this kind of uncertainty you have at this age. You don't want to fall into depression. You know you have a lot of energy and that you're going to figure something out eventually, but it can be an unsettling time. And I tried to pose in the piece various dilemmas that he's having. The subject, the lyrics of the piece tend to, he'll be thinking one thing and then he'll think, oh no, I'll do that instead, and he'll go somewhere else. And to me, that was kind of an affectionate way of trying to replicate the sort of good-natured confusion that people have at that age. And I think one of the more interesting things about Adam is that it ends with him kind of realizing that California may not be able to provide the kind of job that he would like to do, and that he may have to leave California and go back east to do that, especially to one of the more depressed areas in the Midwest. And of course, for most people growing up in California, this is an unthinkable thought. Generally speaking, everybody wants to stay in California. So I kind of threw in that uncertainty at the end, but he also, he's got a good spirit, and the piece is sung by a wonderful young singer who has good spirit too. So I think he pulled it off very nicely.
Head for the Java Hut, just off the square. Step over the sidewalk scruffies who kissed off the material world. Now here's my man Zeke. We'll take our kayaks to Mad River Saloon. The seabirds wheeling high, so near and yet so far from the answers that we seek. We want to contribute
final person, the one who sang the piece about the young man, Adam, in Arcata, is a young fellow named Tom Zohar, who was making his first recording in working with me. He's worked primarily in musical theater. I've seen him in Sweeney Todd, and he's done most of the major musical theater works of the last 10 or 15 years, and had built quite a reputation for himself in the San Diego and LA area. He moved to New York recently and is doing the same thing here. But he's a game, very energetic, and a particular timbre of his voice suited Adam really well, I thought.
I will remember all the fun we had, chasing utopias and rarely sad. Picture the setting sun over the Pacific's horizon. It will inspire.